Hey guys, it's Brandon. We'll just start off. All right, so our first question comes from one of my patrons on my Patreon page. He goes by the initials PS. Can you recommend any heavy metal instrumental albums? And yes, sir, I can. One of my favorites is Andy James' album, his full album that he put out in 2011. It's not titled, but it does have the song Angel of Darkness on it. And my favorite song on that album is War March. It's just a really awesome song, and I'd love to be able to play that one day. Second one is Travelers by Modern Day Babylon. And my favorite song on that one is the title track, Travelers. I really love the way that album sounds, and it just kind of proves that you can do djent and still have a cool atmosphere going on at the same time. And then my third favorite, Wide Eyes, is the band name. They've actually put out some new material recently, but back a few years ago, they put out an album called Volume, and it had a lot of songs, like almost 30 songs in it. And I especially enjoy the one called Camel Crush. It reminds me of one of my favorite guitarists of old time, Trond Vold. And I've got a lot. That was my drummer. He's talking about our collaboration. This is real time, y'all. I'll read that later. But anyway, their album has a lot of different styles of music that totally threw me off. That's okay. I've gained a lot of inspiration as far as riffing, making riffs and stuff from them just listening to their album. All right, and then now we'll go to YouTube. We'll go with DJ, and his question is, what do you use to record your guitars for your videos, as in program, cables, adapters? DJ, first I would recommend that you go check out my recreation series, and I've started that series, and I will continue it soon. It's my first video in that playlist called Getting Started, and I do talk about my setup, but in short, I'll go ahead and summarize it here. Basically, I've got my guitar, a hookup, a cable. There's no specific cable that I've got, really. Hooks up to my UX2 interface. It's a Line 6. It's because I used to use Podfarm a long time ago. That goes USB into my computer. You'll want drivers called ASIO. It means low latency, so that means when you hit a string, there's not that big delay, because the worst thing that you want is a delay between the time you hit a string and you hear the note, because you can't play in time like that. So lowest latency as possible. The recording program that I use is Reaper, and I also did a video on that, why I use Reaper. So that video on recording should answer your questions, and anybody watching should answer questions also. But if it doesn't, if you need more information, just comment below, ask, and I will do my best to answer. All right, and then we've got Brendan. We've had him before. Nice to see him back. He's asking me, would you consider the style of guitarists like Tom Morello and Buckethead, like their harsh noises and effects, to be real guitar? Or do you think, since it's so synthesized, that it shouldn't be considered real, or that it doesn't take any real skill? Everybody has their own way of expressing themselves on a musical instrument. There's no way you can actually say that that's a real guitar player, that's the way you play it for real, because that's so subjective. That's like saying, that's real music and that ain't music at all. It's everything subjective, so while it's not my cup of tea, that doesn't mean that they're not a real guitar player. It does take real skills to do what they're doing. I mean, what they're doing, I mean, just a person that would just simply pick up a guitar could not do that. You have to have some sort of skill, advanced skill, to do some of the things they're doing. It's just experimental, and it's not traditional. It's not the traditional way to use the instrument. But who's to say that that's wrong? You know, I mean, it's not like we're talking about a moral issue here. It's just simply the way you play an instrument. So I don't like it, but that's just me. So thank you for that question, Brandon. I hope that I answered it for you. And then our last question today is from Jesus. It's kind of weird to say it like this, but that's what his username says. But anyway, he's asking me, would you prefer to have an expensive amp and cheap guitar, or an expensive guitar and cheap amp? I think you've stumped me. I'm trying to figure this out. I'm assuming that we're going to extremes here, okay? So you say that I have a really expensive signature guitar from someone that's awesome, I don't know, whoever, and you're playing through, what do you call those things, those little bitty tiny mini cube amps, those really cheap amps, that you've got all this tone in the guitar, but you can't get it to sound good through a little bitty cheap amp. I don't know, I think you could argue that point both ways, because no, you could say, no, I could make an expensive guitar sound good through a cheap amp because the tone's all in your fingers anyway. I think I would rather have a cheap guitar with an expensive amp. I don't know why I insist on, because this is a jagged edge anyway, they don't intend for this to be thrown around. All right guys, thanks again so much for watching, and if you have any questions and you want to be featured in the next Q&A, please leave your comments below and make sure that you let me know that it is for the next Q&A so I won't answer it right away. Make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss my weekly videos, Wednesday and Saturday. And if you want early access to my videos and other cool perks, that's over at my Patreon, and you can check that out by clicking the orange P below. All right, guys, I'll see you Saturday.